gentlemen, the Model A requires attention again. This time it's the steering box. It doesn't have any excessive play in the steering, but from the get-go it has been leaking quite badly. And that's down to the fact that there aren't really any gaskets in this thing to speak of. So over a month or two, it would just lose all the amount of oil that was in there. I tried fixing the issue using a certain type of grease, which is called flow grease in German. You know, it's next to oil, but it still has some kind of high surface tension, so it doesn't really form droplets or run off anywhere. And I thought, well, that might be, you know, too little amount of lubrication, because now the bushings on the pitman arm won't get lubricated properly. But in fact they did, because shortly after, it began leaking again. So, yeah, it's time to tackle that issue. We've got a special guest today. He does a little bit of modification on the steering box in order to make it leak-proof. While we're at it, we're also going to tackle a couple of other issues. For example, the steering box isn't quite centered properly, meaning that when I steer to the left, everything is fine. But when I steer all the way to the right, then the left wheel is spinning freely and the right wheel hits the brake rods. So, yeah, we're going to try and fix that. And a while back, I installed a different type of steering column bracket, and it requires a third hole to be drilled. That's all you're going to see in this video. Stay tuned, and let's get going. Okay, in this box here is a modified Model A steering box side housing cover component. And before I go into detail about how it was modified, let me put the spotlight on Mr. Paul Shinn here. He is the guy that modified the steering component for me, and he is proper crazy when it comes to Model A Fords. He has got a YouTube channel himself, and if you don't know him already, it's all about Model A's. How to keep them running, how to get them running, what it is like to daily drive one of them, how to drive them. Any sorts of questions that you could have about a Model A, he has probably already answered it in his channel, and it's absolutely worth checking out. I learned a lot from him. He's super kind, and well, the link's in the description if you want to see it. And yeah, thank you, Mr. Shinn, for the steering component, and while I now go check out what you've done for me, how about you can go back to the US again? All right, see ya. Bye. Okay, so what have we got in here?
Dear Adrian, please read these instructions carefully before you screw things up. Step one.
Wait! You can't just throw these away like that!
This here is the modified steering box. It has been modified so heavily that you could mistake it for a headlight visor. And it's actually two of them. And they're going to go onto my car. We've also got a nice grease rag, customized with small sewn-on pieces to, you know, to get into places which you couldn't get to before. Even got a handy catchphrase in there. It's a shirt, obviously. Thank you very much. And then there is a timing wrench. It's got the instructions on how to time your car right here, and it's going to go into my trunk, you know, for on-the-road maintenance if necessary. And that's it. Hang on. Oh yes. I almost forgot. This is the piece that we were looking for, the elephant in the room. Now let me get you in closer and we'll see what Mr. Shinn has done to this thing. Here we have some nice explosion drawings of how the steering box is put together. And you can see the sector shaft or pitman arm running out towards the side here. And this housing is this piece right here. The entire thing gets filled with oil. And all that's going to stop the oil from leaking past the bushings in here is a cork gasket, which isn't even the right size for the bushings. So oil is going to leak past this no matter how new and how tight your steering box is. What Mr. Shinn has done now is bore this housing out for a sealing ring. And to, you know, kill two birds with one stone and give the impression of servo steering, he's also included needle bearings for the sector shaft in here instead of the standard brass bushings. It's supposed to be, take one piece off, put the other piece on, and we of course have to do some adjustment for play and adjustment on the steering box so that we can get the wheels centered right. And what I'm going to do myself is modify the bottom plate on the steering box by soldering on a tube right here. It's going to go above the level of oil in the steering box and therefore seal off the bottom part of the steering box against any leaks. So this here is the bottom plate of the steering box, and the horn rod goes through here like that, and all that seals the oil inside the steering box off from leaking through this hole is a piece of felt washer. Well, it's no surprise that that doesn't work, especially when the washer is pretty old and not really able to absorb anything. So what we're going to do is modify it. We're going to take a piece of tubing, which has the inside diameter of the horn rod, and we're going to solder it to this one. We're going to do a little bit of modifications so they will fit more nicely, but that's essentially what we're going to do. This rod will poke above the oil level in the steering box, and therefore nothing can leak out. While we were soldering this piece, I had the steering box completely open with a yogurt can to catch any grease flowing out of here. And as you can see, there is not terribly much left in there, so yep, it was time to take care of this issue. Now we're going to get the steering box loose at an angle so that I can access the mounting points for the sidearm, and then we're going to go from there. So it turns out you have to remove the starter motor in order to get this thing here past the frame. And word of the street has it that you'll need to remove the pedals in order to get this thing all the way out. And I'm not in the mood to do that right now, so I'm going to do the housing swap right here in the car. So the sector shaft housing just came off, and it looks like someone had hardcore diarrhea in this thing. And there is actually some oil still left in here. Delicious! The way that it looks like in here would rectify to completely take this thing off and take it apart completely, thoroughly clean it, and put it back together. However, I'm still hesitant to do that because, as I said, either the pedals will have to go as they are in the way, or I'm going to have to pull the steering wheel and the splash pan and move the steering column out through the bottom, which I don't really want to do either. I also took the side play adjusting screw out, and it looks terrible. Nice burr on here. When you look at the mating surface, you can see why. So I'm going to have to check if this is hardened, but yeah, this is less than ideal, of course. The weather is telling me to continue on working on this instead of packing my things. We'll see. Got 6 more minutes on the memory card. Convert your Model A from left-hand to right-hand steering, part 1. See you all tomorrow.
The next morning, we had to face the fact that our party had been a disaster. But it had been even worse than that for Hammond.
So nobody took care of this overnight. That's okay. So here it is, all nicely laid out on the workbench. I could have probably done the sector shaft housing swap with the thing in the car, would have been possible, but with the condition it's in, it's just better to, you know, have it in the workshop, out of the car, to be able to, you know, do all sorts of things that you couldn't while the thing is obstructed by engine compartment.
Stop it. Get some help.
Yeah, we'll completely take it apart, see what condition the bearings are in, because if they are full of that nitty-gritty, then they'll need some proper attention. Step one is to pull the horn rod, because I know me, I'm going to damage the end here. Right, that's as far apart as you'll see me take things. I found the sector underneath all that diarrhea, and the side sector shaft seems to be in rather good shape, considering its age. I'm pretty sure this thing has never been rebuilt, maybe with a paint can, but let me bring you in closer. Here is the worm gear, and you can see the surface on here is actually still quite shiny, but when you look at the bearing surfaces at both ends, you can see couple of rust marks here where the rollers were touching and where it was resting. You can actually see that it was sitting for quite some time in this position. That's very bad. A new complete rebuild kit for one of these is way over 300 euros, I think. So, considering it worked fine before I took it apart, I'm just going to pretend I didn't see that, and we'll put things back together. Regarding the sector shaft side play adjusting screw, this thing is soft. Fire bites into it, no problem. This thing, who would have guessed, hard as a coffin nail. So, what I'm going to do is chuck this up and face it to get rid of this stub here. And then I'm going to try with the insert tooling to face this part here. Well, unfortunately, I didn't have any insert tooling that would fit into that tight a corner. So I tried carbide tip tooling, and it just, I mean, it didn't even take the scale off this thing. It's so hard that I really don't have a chance. So, well, what I'm going to do, just like with the bearings, is just put it back together the way it is. Nothing else I can do right now. And for all of those out there that are now screaming, bodge job, band-aid repair, yes, that's exactly what it is. I'm not proud of it, but that's why this video doesn't have the title How to Rebuild Your Steering Box. I was just going to get the leaks fixed. This thing worked fine, and for that sole reason, I'm putting it back together the way it was, minus all of this junk. If this was spinning at 3000 RPM, totally different case. But the way I see it, it's going to work fine the way it is, and with the modified sector shaft housing, it's going to be leak-proof as well. So, that's where we're going to go now. Well, that's starting to look like a steering box now. We've now got several ways to screw things up. The first adjustment you saw me make was the axial play in the steering column, which is just this thing here which presses against the bearing race and eliminates any play. Next, we're going to do the axial play in the sector shaft. You may be able to see that there is a slight amount of play in there. And then this whole thing on here is able to, it has play between the holes here. And what you have here is an eccentric sleeve nut kind of a thing. And by turning it, we're going to adjust the mesh between the sector shaft and the worm. Eliminate any play like that. We're going to go from the center position, so where this thing would be steering straight. After that, we're going to adjust the centralization rivet. You can see it's pointing straight up and down right now, and you can equalize the amount of play left from center and right from center by turning this thing. Don't forget your gasket, like I did. Okay, steering to the left, you can see that the play gets a lot more, and steering to the right, it should probably then bind up. No, not really. There is a tight spot here. Scientific tooling. Okay, I'm going to measure at this point here, roughly perpendicular. So 1 mm and 2/10 is the play. And then on the left. Now, if you wish to adjust a steering box like this yourself, then I highly suggest you pay the website modelabasics.com a visit, because not only do they describe what to do, but they have detailed 3D models of why you do it and help you understand what you're doing. And with me, it just always helps to understand why I'm doing stuff instead of just doing it. Yep, we've got more play on the left, so I'm going to turn the screw left. This much, maybe? I don't know. Tighten everything back up. We're going to call that equal. And now we'll have to redo this adjustment with the eccentric. I'll save you that. And that's the steering box adjusted properly. There is no tight spots anywhere, and even at the tightest spot there is just a hair bit of play, maybe a tenth or so on, right out here. And nearly no axial play in the shaft, no radial one of course because of the needle bearings, and there is also no play in the steering column without it binding. So I would call that adjusted. Done everything correctly, which might just be the case, we could now fill this thing with oil and there would be no leaks. So that's exactly what I'm going to do now. Fill it with oil, have some lunch, and come back to see an oil bath in this workshop. Well, it's about 2 hours later, and there is good news and bad news. The good news is no leaks. It's completely bone dry all the way around, even on the problematic area. But those that know Model A's will have probably spotted already that this notch is supposed to be down here. That's not all bad. Luckily, I only put silicone sealant onto one side of the gasket. But of course, it means we'll have to drain most of the oil out of here. Reverse this damn thing down there. Well, it kind of worked. Minimal spillage. I'm actually pretty sure that there is a more elegant way to do this.
Hello.
So as you can see, the issue of the wheel hitting the brake rod still prevails. When I steer all the way to the right, the pitman arm moves toward the rear of the car. It obviously moves too far, so one idea would be to put a spacer behind the worm, because if the worm is further up in the steering column, then the pitman arm won't be able to move back as far. So until the day that I'll have to take it apart again, I'm just going to leave it as is. One important side note, if you had this clamp here off and rotated the shaft, be aware that that affects the engine timing. In my case it was blatantly obvious because this rod here would hit the stops in the distributor before it would hit the stops on the steering column. So what I did was loosen this clamp up and then rotated the steering column just a tiny bit back and forth until I had the timing where I wanted it. Well, everything's back together in here, and taking a look inside the steering box, I am very pleased to say that it is filled to the brim with oil. After 1.5 days, not a drop hanging from the bottom of the steering box, so I'm pretty positive that we've now cured the leak issue. And all that's remaining now is a test drive. It's pretty rainy today, maybe the streets will dry up. Usually I'm not afraid to take the car out in the rain, but when I don't know if the steering starts death wobbling, then I want to be on the safe side. Look, I can't wait for a whole day. I'm just way too curious. So we're going to go for a ride now. It's supposed to be dry for the next hour or so, and we'll be very careful.
Much play when I took it apart versus when I put it back together. Anyways, seems to be running fine. Luckily, after a whole lot of work, thank you, Paul Shinn, for your excellent work of machining the sector shaft housing. And I'll see you all next time. There is still stuff to be done on this car. Alright, take care. That's it for today. Bye.